Yo guys, what's up? It's your boy Jsolo, and today we have, you know what it is, All The Tea Podcast with my boy. Say what's up. Ziko. You're a bitch.
Wasty. Hey, that's me. I'm on the podcast. Hey, y'all. I'm Ziko. Ziko Dozy.
Yeah, his Insta will be linked right here. So we're doing the second installment of the All The Tea Podcast. And this one is, it's gonna be good. So how you been, my G? How you been?
Excited. It's been blessed, cuz I've been at home. I'm eating nice.
Eating nice, hey? Yo, college didn't give us good food, hey?
College was trash, bro. I starved in April.
Yo, don't be saying that. I don't want them to come out and sue me. But yeah, no, it's facts. We all be eating nice now. I got my tan back, bro. That thing was nice, bro. I was white as hell back in BC, bro.
Okay.
Did you see that thing on the news? The 5 foot bagel thing?
Yeah, I've been trying to talk to you about that.
Oh my god. For y'all that don't know, I'm gonna roll the clip right now.
A customer just loses it because he says women reject him over his size.
Why is it okay for women to say, oh, you're 5 feet on dating sites? You should be dead. That's okay?
Who said that to you here? Nobody.
Women in general have said it on dating sites. You think I'm making up?
Now watch what happens when another customer tells him to calm down.
Dude, you wanna step outside? You wanna step outside? Huh? I'm not scared of you, pal.
Then somebody else tells him to cool it.
Go ahead and attack me, big.
Oh my god.
Back on his feet, he aims his anger at the female staff working the counter.
All you women treat just like all of you. All of you. Yeah, all of you.
You need to go.
No, you women need to stop being so.
Just look at this customer's bemused reaction. The crazy video took place here at Bagel Boss in Bayshore, Long Island.
Basically, that had me wild, bro. Like, you know what? It's so funny because I saw a meme the other day. I'm going to insert the meme right here. And it was basically, you know, the Baywatch that The Rock was in?
Yeah.
So I saw like a post. It said, what girls see? And then it was like, they had like Zac Efron and that other dude, really, really short. And it said 5'10 and a half.
Nope.
And then it had like three girls standing next to each other and it said 5'11.
Nope.
And they were all super short. And then there was 6 foot and it had Dwayne The Rock Johnson, full sized, standing next to them by comparison. And it has me so.
Yo,
how do you feel about that video?
Okay. Yo, people might come for my neck for this, right? But I blame women, low-key. I'm blaming girls.
You know what? I'm on that side, too. Oh.
And here's what I mean, right? Yeah, you shouldn't be out here yelling in a bagel store. I think you just go get bagels, right? But he was making facts. He was like, yo, all these girls on these dating sites be saying I'm too short because I'm 5 feet. And I feel sorry for you guys who are under 6 feet.
Okay.
You know, because I'm out here in the...
Oh, my God.
That's right. I plug myself 6 feet, of course.
Just because you are 6 foot. Like, you're not even, like...
I'm on the cusp. I'm on the cusp, man. I hate that bare minimum.
I know, but I feel you, bro. It's so... Because, like, you know what? Yeah, I'm going to get some stick for this, too. But, like, I feel like girls who are like 5'5 minimum don't have a say.
You're trifling, baby. Yeah.
If you 5'10... And you can chat because if you're 5'10, you're like my queen. You know all the guys that you're going for at that range are, you know, because like in America the average height is 5'9. You know that?
Did ask?
Yeah, 5'9 in America. So that dude who was 5 foot, you know, he was getting it.
He's tiny.
But I understand. But it's like I understand preference. You know, everybody has their own preference and stuff. But like, yo, if you're 5 foot. 5 or you're 5'6", 5'7", anywhere between 5'5" and 5'8". No, 5'5" and 5'7", or 5'7", 5'8", and you are trashing on niggas because they're not 6 foot plus. Shut up.
Honestly, you know what? We should all just admit we're all low key superficial. That's just the way it is.
But I mean, like, for them, to those people who are that height, no shame, no hate. I don't want backlash. But everyone taller than you is 6 foot. There you go. That's how you should see it.
Pretty much.
And you know what? Superficiality should not, like, we should quickly move to, like, because, you know, even me these days, I can't cap. I know I'm straight capping. I was about to cap on recording. I was about to cap.
I would have called you.
But I'm saying, like, you know, looks are only, like, half the story, you know?
Are you sure about that?
You know, you could find a painting, but then, you know, she could be completely dead. Same way, vice versa. A girl could find a fine-looking dude for 2 seconds.
I don't know. Some guys will willingly take a girl who just fine as anything, but she might be, like, dead when it comes to, like, mentally. You know what I mean?
I mean, like, yeah, but then it's like, what are you looking for in that relationship? Or that whatever you're doing? Like, you're just looking for a straight... beep! You're looking for... That's like... Come on. Like, you can... There's Tinder.
Yeah, that's true. That's very true.
Oh, the sun's going down. Like, stop, son.
I feel like superficiality, like, if you're a guy, right, and you're looking for a fine shawty, and you see her, right, you're not thinking, damn, you know, I can see her brain. She's so smart. Nah, you're looking at, damn, she got a nice face. You know, the back kind of big, too. And it's just, that's what you're looking at. And then when you start talking to her, that's when you start to see the little smaller details. So I think, like, looks alone count for, like, 60%.
Okay, no, I would say, because I feel like if you throw it in, like, different encounters, like, I think first impressions, looks count for, like, 85%.
Yeah, facts.
Like, first encounters. Everything. Because you can have a first encounter, and then it can be awkward as shit, and that 85% can made up nothing. But once you get past the, like, the greetings and, like, the, what is it? Just, like, past the mundane stuff, then it's when, like, personality starts becoming more. Because,
yeah,
I don't know, if I can't hold a conversation with you for longer than 5 minutes, yo, I don't care what back you got, bro. I'm not the one to bruck off the back.
You don't bruck off the back, you know?
Yeah, bro. Okay. But that's an interesting topic, bro. People nowadays, this is facts, but, like, people on text is a whole different thing. But people face to face.
Face to face.
I feel like we're losing more of this humanly connection. Like, people are failing to, what is it? To hold conversations. Like, I don't know if you saw my last video, like the Omegle thing that I did, right? That was just for shits and giggles. But, like, when I did Omegle on my own and stuff like that, you know, without the cameras rolling, because the second the camera's rolling, everybody's like, oh my god, are you famous?
Okay.
But no, after, like, before that kind of thing, it was like, you know, conversations would die out. And I get it's with strangers because you have nothing in common. But, like, I feel like there's a lot to do with the idea that, like, that awkwardness that people that have nowadays when in, like, with public interactions is minimized when you text.
Yeah, true, man.
Because you're not, you don't, and I could be, you know, capping, but, like, I feel like texts convey very, very little emotion. Besides, like, three words. I hate you and I love you.
You seen it when someone sends you, like, a meme or something. The guy, like, haha, laughing emoji.
Yo, when you send a thing, what is it? Like a meme, and then someone responds, haha, but it's not a funny meme. That's just, you get called out.
Literally, just like, fake laughs. Like, conversations, sometimes I just see BA. I can't be bothered to just go around between the people. It's long.
I know.
It's just like, yo, this interaction is cool and all, but, like, nah, just text me next time, bro.
I know. There's moments for everything. That's facts. But I mean, like, I feel like just in general, conversations these days are very, very minimal. And sometimes that can be good. Like, you can get short, sweet, and to the point. But, like, that's your true. Average conversation, I feel like it's, like, they're dead these days. Because I feel like it's more... Not. I'm not calling out humans, but because I'm a human too. I don't know what that. But I'm saying, like, we've become, like, more tech savvy, more robotic, because it's like we're so willing to, like, text. I've had people call me, deadass, like, call me, and then say text me and hang up the phone.
Okay.
And I'm like, you literally just got my attention to tell me text me. What? Just can you not say it? Like, it's so much easier to speak.
Yeah, that's extra.
I know, but there are people like that these days, bro. I'm the same people who, you know, don't have a brain in their head, you know?
That's true.
But yeah, no, I just feel like, you know, it's good, you know, everything has pros and cons in life. Everything, you know.
Facts.
But you know, this technology thing is like, or it's like, you know, when you try and chat to Gel, and then, you know,
yeah,
the one where you just like, you know, just be direct, man. Be straightforward. People beating around the bush. Yesterday, I was talking to one of my friends, right?
Yeah.
And he was trying to chat to this girl, right?
Yeah.
Like, on text, right? And yeah, my guy was beating around the bush so hard that her response was, "I'll think about it."
Oh, that's raps then.
I'm like, bro, if you gave me the phone, 3 minutes, I'll have her waiting for you. Pum pum yera.
Stop capping.
Hey, don't gas yourself up like that. You don't move like that.
Shush, yes I do.
You don't move like that.
You know, hey, good and well I move like that.
We have to finalize what I was trying to say.
Yeah, go
the
ahead.
Big 5 foot bagel guy.
Yeah.
We stop clowning guys for being short, or we all just agree we're pretty superficial in what we want. Some people want a tall guy. Some people want a girl with a big back. Some people want a girl who's smart.
Ziko, why are you talking about yourself? I know you're just describing yourself.
Stuff. Huh?
I know you're just describing yourself, bro.
I'm not describing myself, but I do have my preferences.
Yeah, we all know.
At me, please.
No, but yeah, no, you're not. Everyone, low-key, no one can say they're not superficial. I want to meet someone like that. Because everyone has, you know, preferences, and you know, there's not such thing as good or bad preferences, unless it's like, you know, kind of weird, or they're like,
yeah, let's be freaky with it.
Yeah, you know, some weird kinky BDSM stuff. Then you about to slide the other way, cause homie don't play that. I'm a child of God. But I feel like he didn't have to go that far.
Okay.
I feel like he didn't have to go that far. Like I feel like he was in a bagel store and he called out like dating apps. That's like the wrong place. Like let's say he's in like a AA meeting. That would make sense. Like, I'm an alcoholic.
So?
I'm an alcoholic because, you know, these girls just keep saying I'm 5 foot. But I'm 5'1".
Oh my God, that was so funny.
That kind of stuff. Like, that would make, like, there's a right time for everything. Like, you know, personally, I don't believe in going over the top.
What do you mean?
Like, I know people in my life, family, friends, lovers, all that kind of stuff. I know people who, you know, that situation where it's like, you know, the common thing where it's like, call the manager or something like that, those kind of people.
Yeah, the barbecue Becky's of the
like
life, you know?
I feel like that's so unnecessary. Like, I feel like, okay, I feel like once, okay, I started this conversation with you, I'm not gonna like, you know, demoralize you or like diminish your like, not ego or pride, but like your stature or the way like you know, command yourself, your confidence, by, you know, making you seem inferior because you made a mistake.
Okay, yeah, I get that.
Like, people are so quick to like judge, or like, you ever see those videos where it's like the one the jokes where it's like never disrespect a waiter, because you know they know the cooking, and then they're like, it was one with like Ryan Reynolds. I'll see if I can find the clip and I'll play it.
But I still have some salad left.
Oh, well, would you like me to take the food back and bring it out in a few minutes?
Yeah, and let it dry out under the heat lamps. Just give me the food. Wait. Did that waitress listen to a word I said? This steak is medium rare. I asked for it medium, and I wanted extra gravy on my mashed potatoes. Let me ask you something. How hard is your job? How intelligent do you have to be to take a food order? Jesus!
Ma'am, you're absolutely right, and I apologize. I'm gonna get this fixed for you right away.
Good. Now I can finish my salad.
Gentlemen, we have our first official biatch of the day.
Oh, come on, guys. She wasn't that bad, was she?
Well, Amy, it's your table. You decide.
She was a fucking bitch. Do it.
The first thing we do is we add a little extra gravy to the mashed potato.
Oh,
That's it. Good job, buddy. Good job. Nice one. Followed by a thin spread of cheese for your garlic bread. Some fromunda cheese. Yeah, make us proud. Fresh from the taint. We like this. Good. Up next, what we're gonna do is...
Yeah, how about a little guacamole for the steak?
Whoa. What are you doing? Come on, man, you can't be mixing Mexican and continental. Come on, man, I thought you was better than that.
Have a little garlic salt.
That's what I'm talking about. Finesse, baby.
These guys have a deep commitment to their job.
Finally, a garnish of alfalfa sprouts adds a touch of class. Touch of class to any meal.
There we go.
Oh, God.
Good stuff. Here you go, ma'am. I had the chefs take extra special care of it for you. And I'm truly sorry for the inconvenience. Mm-hmm. You know, we should probably feel guilty, but she broke the cardinal rule. Don't fuck with people that handle your food.
And they gave it back to her and she ate that shit. And I was like, that's grim. But like it, you should never get that far even. But I'm saying like, I feel like everything can be, you know how there's a saying like, take life with a grain of salt or something like that?
Yeah.
Yeah, take that salt out. Just replace it with sugar. I feel like with a level head, and some you know, open-mindedness and some understanding, you know, life, you can go a long way. If you're if you're agitated from the cut, no, can't do that. So like that's how I think that like, he could have really taken that situation differently. He could have been, you know, he could have talked to somebody. You know, he was pent up. I don't know what these women were saying to him.
Yeah, this has been building up for at least like 3 years. This has been like constant denial.
Yeah, bro, it's been building up for 4 feet, man. What you talking about?
Shut up.
He's gonna come for my neck, bro. I'm gonna get copyright strike.
On the topic of putting hair follicles and stuff in food.
Yeah.
You know how people in the States be out here licking ice cream?
Bro! I swear to God, the one of the stores, like one of the, I don't know, 7-Eleven or something like that, near me, one place, I saw the sign inside, it said, please ask employee to open. And I'm that girl's facing what? She's facing 20 years, bro.
No, that's a dude. Another guy's facing 20 years. She's facing like 6.
Yeah, but like that's mad. They're doing bare time, bro. 6 years? 6 times 365?
Yeah, because you're licking ice cream and putting it right back. It's disgusting.
I know. And that's like, and everyone's doing it. Like, they took the fall for this movement. But they're such dumb movements, man. I don't care who does it. Y'all are all im-bay-ciles.
Im-bay-ciles, right? Not even imbeciles.
Yeah,
im-bay-ciles,
bro.
Imbeciles,
all right. Matic. But I swear, challenges, bro, when did challenges start? Like, if you really think back, like, challenges have become a big way to promote yourself.
What was the first challenge, though? That's the real question.
Bro,
I set it off.
Bro, I don't even know. I don't even know where all these challenges came from. Remember when we tried to do the challenge for Lil Wayne's thing? he even put a tweet out like, yo, do the challenge or something like that. And we're like, oh. That's
nice. Yeah, but real talk, what was the first challenge that got people like all invested in it? Hey, it was that ice bucket. Was it the ice bucket one? I know I did that.
I think that was one of the early ones.
Yeah, I know.
That was definitely when people started getting, because that one was like you had to nominate people. Nowadays, if you do a challenge, you're not nominating anybody. Anyone can just pick
up a
thing and be
and
like.
That one was for a good cause. We're not out here just eating food in Superstore and putting it back.
Yeah.
It's like you order the footlong, right? You take a bite and then put everything back where it was.
No, it's like.
that's literally what you just did.
That's facts, bro. Oh my God. That's basically the whole thing. Yeah, no, people are just. That's just weirdos, man. Some people
don't say people, that's America. No, boy, okay? I put that on America. Don't tweak it. Canada's cool.
Shut up. No, you're not. You culture vultures, bro.
Ken is relaxed right now, man. You don't see what's going through stress.
You can still eat your ice cream. Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Watch is gonna come over there. It's gonna cross the border too.
We can still eat our ice cream, man. I might go get some right now.
Look at you trying to be woke. Get out of here.
No. I'm sleep on that ish. Don't even start with woke, man. I'm sleeping on you woke people these days.
Yo, people who are woke. Bro, okay. I'm not even gonna cap. Whenever I come back to the States or I go to different countries.
Yeah.
Slang, when did slang become so prevalent? I remember back in the day, slang was like so indigenous. Like it was like, you rarely saw it. Like—
Are you sure about that? I don't think so.
Like, I'm not even capping. Like now I go to everywhere in like the world kind of stuff. Cause it's not, I don't even think it's like, it's based on the dialect anymore. It's just based on your location. Cause you got English slang in like 5 different forms. You can get it in Jamaica, you can get it in England, you can get it in America. Like, it's English.
Yeah,
but there's, like, so many different slang. But the thing is, like, I thought, like, maybe it's just because I was a kid and I didn't really care for slang when I was a kid. But it seems like there are so many. Like, every time I come to, like, new places, like, if I come back to the States, like, my home kind of stuff, the slang here, it's like, if I repeated the words to you guys, in Canada, you'd be like, what are you saying? And then vice versa. Like, if I took a dude from Toronto and I brought him here and he started speaking, everybody would be like, what tired youth is this?
Well, because we only beg the slang that, like, people are really putting on right now. Toronto slang, we beg the scene. UK slang, we're begging that. Jamaican slang, we're begging that. Because that's what's been putting on right now.
I mean, that's true. That's facts. But, like, I just feel like there's a huge growth in like new slang and stuff like that. I feel like there is, bro. You see new words getting added into the dictionary?
Facts. Yo, people be making up just words. People just making up words now.
Bro, it's Cardi B's fault. I'm adding her right now.
Facts, that's true.
I'm just kidding. If you ever watch this, Cardi B, I love you.
I don't remember anyone saying ochre until she did.
Bro, it has its own definition, bro. I saw it. I don't think it's in Webster yet, but I swear it's in one of the published dictionaries, man.
Yeah, that's embarrassing.
It's because of the Jimmy Kimmel show. Man.
Nah, that's too much.
She went on that show and she told everyone what ochre in like 3 different tones means. 3 different words.
Nah.
That's like going up to someone and saying hello in 3 different accents and saying this means hello when you're saying this to this person. in this kind of... I was like, yo, you should just trip it. Yeah. But no. You know what? But no, let's talk about that wokeness. Cause what is your deal with like you know what? Funny thing is, I won't cap. When the word woke came out, I jumped on that train so late. I did not know.
I jumped on that H early.
I did not know what woke meant for so long. I literally thought it meant niggas were awake.
Oh brother.
And I was like, hey, I mean, we sleep for like.
You're awake.
I was like, we sleep for like 8 hours of the day. So, okay. Everyone wakes up. What are we now at society of waking up people?
And bro, you're actually slow sometimes.
Shush, no, I'm not. I might be. This is gonna go check it out. This one here. Igor, I just want to live.
What?
You know the Igor movie? You never watched it? The one in the...
Shut up.
He's saying, shit, shut up. Okay, yeah, but basically, what is your problem with woke? What do you define the problem as? If you had to put it into a statement.
It's too much. It's low-key, it's too much. Like, you start seeing stories, and you start, like, reading about people doing some of the wackest-ish just to be, like, woke, just to be like, yeah, you know, I'm socially progressive, and it's just like... And yeah, I think you're progressing too fast, cuz... We should slow it down, take our time, we ain't gotta run there.
So you mean like people who are growing up too fast kind of thing?
No, are you dumb? No, I mean like, I can think of an example on top of my head. And that might sound like I'm bullshitting or anything like that. But I'm just saying like, people act like so woke with stuff that's like, you're just like, why though? Like, they go overboard when they see you using a plastic straw.
Bro, okay, wait. There's, you gotta watch out. There's bare environmentalists out here, right?
Yeah.
But, like, I get into this conversation a lot. right?
Yeah.
You can't complain if you're not doing anything active about it.
That's very true.
People will penalize individuals for doing things that they do like in their everyday life that's mundane, right? Yes, we should change and stuff like that, but penalizing or reprimanding or like, you know, asserting yourself on one person won't change jack shit unless that person is the leader of the free world.
That is very true.
Like what happens is you get people who basically, you know, they'll impact individuals' lives, right? They'll go and they'll like, when someone uses a plastic bag at a supermarket, they'll be like, oh, you use plastic bags, you should change. Okay, that's cool, that's good, right?
Yeah.
But firstly, you gotta pause. Watch your tone. Because 100% of the time, people are not gonna listen to you. Like, what was that thing? I'm lost for words now, but there's a word, lecturing. People are, like, I'm gonna rough estimate, 75% of lectures, people don't listen to. When you pass like 7 years of age, because the first 7 years of your life is very impressionable. You know, if you do something and your parents reprimand you, you know, you're not gonna do it again unless you become older and stuff like that. You know, because you're a very impressionable time. But basically, what I'm saying is like, people are quick to lecture instead of properly educate. And I know like lecturing is like what they call it in college, like lecture halls and lectures and stuff like that to teach. But I'm saying people are quick to like negatively, you know, just go at someone for doing something that they're accustomed to, right? Whether right or wrong, right? You gotta show alternatives. You gotta come with a plan of action that, you know, tells people why the alternative is benefits more, you know, what the pros are of it, why is the what you're doing now so negative, and show people what, like, show side effects. Like, people talk about the turtle and the straw thing, right?
Yeah, as sad, that's kind of long if you think about it.
As sad as that is, right?
Yeah, but
how many people, there are seven...
Go back to what you said, though, about, hey, you gotta, like, break it down for... That's kind of long for math, you know?
No. Like, you don't gotta come at people with
I have to listen to all that.
You don't gotta come at people with essays. I'm just saying, if you wanna tell someone that this is gonna hurt the environment, don't say like, oh, look at you, you hurt the environment. What the f? No? Come at them like, oh, did you hear that this does this to the environment? Or.
Okay, that's better.
Like, you gotta come with a grain of sugar, like I say, guys. Listen to me. But it's like, you know, like, or like, if you want to talk about like what it does to the sea animals or like the ecosystem and stuff like that, right? You want to talk about the turtle, because I've seen the turtle everywhere, right?
There are
7 billion people in this world, plus or minus a couple hundreds of millions and stuff like that, right?
Yeah.
All 7 billion people have not seen that turtle get a straw pulled out of his nose. Right?
I haven't even seen a turtle get a straw pulled.
That's what I'm saying. I saw it like one time, stuff like that. If you want to spread awareness, what you need to do is you need to attack the most high. And I'm saying like government, you know, government leaders, famous people, people who have huge followings, huge backings. Like, you know, when like even people who like, look at that girl who licked the ice cream. How many millions of people, followed her and did the same thing?
Facts. Imagine she licked the ice cream and then said, "Hey, yo, you know plastic bags be killing our animals."
Yo, have you ever seen that meme where it was like some Pornhub meme or something like that? It was about to like do something sexual and then it completely switches to like dolphins and stuff. It's like, did you know it was so? If I can find it, I'll show it to you. But basically, like, she did that one thing. Or think about, you know, that guy who was talking to the kid, like pretending to have a whole ass conversation.
I think so.
No, he was like some guy with his, I think it was his son, but they were sitting on the couch and they were talking about a movie, but they would look like they were having a whole conversation because the kid was a baby.
I ain't seen that.
I'll show you, but that thing got like hundreds of millions of views on Facebook, bro. It blew up overnight. I'm not saying that everything has to be an overnight sensation.
Yeah.
But I'm saying if you're the type of person to lecture someone about, you know, like the environment, or lecture something about being too woke and not go out and do something, what are you doing with your time? Like, you're just wasting breath. Because if you're the person who lectures someone, but then goes stands outside of the world leaders, like, you know, that kid who that girl who she was on the news or something because she quit school in Sweden.
Oh yeah, yeah. She's doing something.
Like, she went to a random person and she told them, oh, you're not, you shouldn't be doing this and that, and then she's out doing that. That's respectable, because look at the following that she has now, and she didn't even care. Look, did she broadcast anything on social media? I have not seen it. People broadcast her on social media, right?
Facts.
What I'm saying is, she went out with a goal to change the world as little as, because she's one person, but she wants to make a huge impact. Every single person who has the mindset to do something, don't shortcut yourself. That's all I'm saying. Like, if you're so passionate about what you do, if it's about saving the environment, if it's about, you know, being the best career-wise, if it's being, you know, the best musician, best stuff like that, don't, like everyone will say that, don't let your words be lost in the wind. Like, follow them. Like, make it so. Create the path, you know what I'm saying?
That was beautiful.
Bro, yeah, you're inspiring people.
I mean, that's, I'm just saying, like, because, you know, woke is good. I think wokeness is good. It might be the one that you're talking about. I can come to an agreement that there are some people that are, you know,
overbearing, man.
Overbearing with their wokeness. Like, yeah. they think they're Mahatma Gandhi out here with the... If you, you know, go out and say, like, you know, something, or you try and change people's minds about the environment, versus if Kylie Jenner goes and does it, who's going to get more people following them?
That's true. Yo, Kylie Jenner, of course.
That's what I'm saying. So, if you want to, if you know you're not at a place in time or a place right now that you can affect millions, go to a place that can, or make it your livelihood to become that place, and then change minds. Because if you sit and, you know, badger someone in hopes that they change and then you feel content with your life, okay, that's cool. As long as you're happy.
You're really not doing anything, but
But you're not doing too much. You want to go and make an impact, so you know that your kid's future, or, you know, your future and all that kind of stuff is sustained. Because I'd be hearing nonsense like, we got 13 years on this planet of sustainable living.
Where are you getting these numbers from?
No, 13 years of sustainable living, meaning that we can still live, but we will be over like the cap. Like, we gotta cut back. We're already stretching it right now. Supposedly, if you live like the average...
Y'all got no PhD in, like, whatever, don't be talking. I don't know where y'all getting these numbers from.
Yo.
Someone's 13, another guy said 25, some guy said 2.
No, I heard scientists say... No, I'm not saying the world is going to end, but I heard them say, like, you know how we're using the resources right now?
Yeah.
The resources are going to run out in about 13 years, kind of thing. That's what they're saying. We'll still have the world. Right. Y'all be on a resource... You'll be on a resourceless world. That's what they're saying.
That's peak for us.
But yeah, but it's like, you know, it's funny because if you live like the average American, supposedly it's like you need 6 worlds. We ain't got no damn 6 worlds. We got 1. We can't even go to Mars yet. The moon, we gotta pay millions to go there. We don't know. Yeah. But no, like, I understand what you mean about, like, the wokeness, but, like, you know, it has its pros and cons, I say.
Facts. We just leave it there.
That's fact. But, you know, with wokeness, you know, comes nosy people. People that want to be up in your...
Let me tell you a story. Let me tell you a story about how nosy some people can really get, right?
Tell me, bro.
So, when I was in university, right?
Mm-hmm.
And, like, I was... We
He's saying it was like you finished 4 years PhD. I have a wife and 3 kids.
Yo, I'm done first year. At that point, I can say when I was, okay. Right? So, you know, we touch parties and we touch, like, functions like that, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so I put some of that stuff on my Snapchat. And I'm just like, yeah, you know, I'm trying to share it with my friends. And then I come home, and my mom's on my head talking about, oh, so I saw you doing all this in school. And I'm like, how do you know this? And she's like, so this, my one friend, her daughter has you on Snapchat. And so she's preying everything I'm doing on Snapchat and telling her mom, who's then telling my mom. And I'm thinking, yo, what the hell?
Bruh.
Like, you get, like, that's how deep this nosiness gets. Like, y'all have nothing better to do with your time. So you're out here seeing what I'm doing on Snapchat, telling your mom so you can tell my mom. Like, what business do you have with that?
That's facts. Yo, but some parents even go as far as to create burner accounts, bro. I got DMs from some family members, like the parents, not the kids. And it's like, and I can tell their burner accounts because, you know, the parents don't, you know, try their hardest to cover up who they are. But it's like they'll just be sending me DMs and I'm like, huh? How'd you get here?
I never understood that burner account shit.
I want to create a burner account for when I become famous. I want to be like KD. I want to do this thing.
Just trash on everyone who hates you?
No. I have a burner account. Like, I actually have one. And it's been, I created it back in 2011. Because I was so deadass back then. I wanted to create a YouTube channel back then. But I thought, it's not sustainable. Look what happened now. PewDiePie created a YouTube channel in 2011. Hey, he has 96.
Later late on it.
Hey, better late than never. And I'm going to keep growing. You heard me.
All right. Say less.
Gotta keep working on that. But yeah, no, I understand, like, nosiness, like, but there's levels, bro. And each level gets me mad. Like,
mine was extreme as anything.
If I get up and I, like, and I go and walk away, and someone's like, where you going? Yeah. I'm gonna get, does it involve you?
It doesn't. And you know what? We can get this shit twisted, right? We can just be like, if you ask someone, yo, how their day's going? Are they feeling all right? You low-key being nosy.
Yeah, but I mean, like, there's situations where you can, you know, say that. Because, like, let's say someone would have, you know, someone was having a bad day. And then you ask them. That's not really being nosy. You got a purpose for it. And so sometimes there's purposes where you ask someone about their day and it's because you want to, you know, slide in there.
That's what you do, huh?
No.
And just exposed yourself.
Never. I'm a child of God.
How you operate. You operate.
This right here. It's a child of God right here.
Okay.
And then, but no, but I mean, like, or like, let's say you're sitting with a girl, right?
Yeah.
She may be a piff thing. She may be your thing. She may not be. But your phone goes bzzz. Who's that? What the? Does that concern you? No.
That's true.
I'm saying it now. Y'all can at me if you want. I don't care if it comes to my Snap, my Insta, or my messages. People, when your phone goes off, right? Let's say you a faithful ass nigga or you a faithful ass chick. Your phone buzzes for any apparent reason. When your person that you're with confronts you like, why'd it buzz? What'd you do that kind of stuff? That immediately created a rift.
Oh.
I don't know about that, man. You might be taking it too personal.
No. Because if you truly trust someone, and I know it's gonna suck in the future if you find out that you can't trust that person, but you know, you wanna have, like, have you ever watched those things on YouTube? Like, I follow a YouTube channel, I don't know if you know, Udi something? Udi Pranks or something like that? He does like those gold digger pranks, right?
Oh yeah?
And it's like, I watch them cause it's so funny. And they're not all on women, but the majority are. But I'm not saying anything about that. I'm just saying that, like, when you catch a gold digger, right? Like, the funniest thing is when they victimize themselves. Like, when you turn everything around, like you've been recorded, you're caught in the act, all that kind of stuff, and then you say, oh, you put me here. Nigga, what?
Nah, see, that's tweaking. They're tweaking with that.
Like, let's say those situations, let's say that person, because that was a test, and they failed the test, right?
Yeah.
But I know that everyone wants to trust, you know, the person they're with. Or they even, it doesn't even have to be like a partner. If you're a friend and stuff like that, you want to trust someone that you connect with, right?
True.
Unless they show that they can't be, like, you know, trusted and stuff like that, like, blatantly, I feel like you should write it out. But don't like, mess yourself up while you're writing it out. Because, like, let's say those gold diggers and stuff like that, let's say those pranks, they didn't do them, right?
Yeah.
How many more months, how many more years, how many more, like, how much more time would you have had with that person? No one can know. But I feel like it's pretty unfair to do that to someone. You know? Because I feel like it's unfair to test someone like that. Because look at the parameters that you're testing that person in. You're putting money in their face, right? And I'm not saying you have to be a gold digger, but you know that saying, money, you know, like money isn't everything, you know, money doesn't bring happiness.
Yeah.
Yeah, it doesn't bring you happiness. It brings you stability, which can free up time to bring you happiness. When you're stable and you have the time and the ability to go do stuff that you like, your life is gonna become so much more happier, right?
Yeah.
When you're penny pinching and you're running around trying to make money, and you don't have time to focus on yourself, your life's not gonna be the greatest. And it's not, you know, you may, in that situation, people accustom it to money. They say, oh, money's the reason my life is going shit. But then when people get to that echelon where they're rich and they say, oh, how are you so happy? They don't say money made me happy. They say, oh, doing this, this, and this made me happy. But what fueled that ability is what I'm saying.
So are you saying that we should just allow gold diggers?
I'm saying that we shouldn't attack everyone who looks at like money as like as a immediate goal, because you don't know what their end product is. Because that person could find their happiness once they find the money. You know what I'm saying? It's because I feel like, because look, listen, the only distaste that I have against that is that like the situation they put them in, they put good looking people, money, yeah, houses, cars, a gig, like, oh, we can make you a top model. They tune in to like, it's like semi sadistic if you think about it from like a philosophy point of way, but like they use the significant partners information about the person they're, you know, doing. Like, let's say I'm dating this chick, right? And she knows I want to be a model, right?
Yeah.
And then she gets picked off by the pranks guy, and then she tells him, oh, he really wants to be an aspiring model, right?
Alright.
You put money, you put maybe a good looking girl, you put opportunity and all that in my face, and you put that modeling gig. You know, it's unfaithful to say no. I mean, it's unfaithful to continue, and I understand that, and I do not promote unfaithful things, but I feel like it's unfair to people. Because if you have that opportunity, all you want in life is the opportunity to do what you want to do, right?
See, yeah, I was about to like cut you off there, because like, if you would easily jump for everything you had there, then I feel like you never really, like, well, what you had like currently with your girl, you kind of just like cut that off and you're just like, yeah, I don't really need that because I'm rushing for this. It kind of just exposes who you really are, if you ask me.
Okay, that makes sense. That's a valid. I see people who have 2-year relationships break up like it was nothing. And it's like, what were the 2 years worth?
That's cold. That's a waste of time.
That's what I'm saying. Like as long as you, like, okay, let's say you find a stable girl and stuff like that, like a down-to-earth chick, right? Like, I'm saying,
yeah,
there has to be, the reason why these people are moving on, I feel like there has to be a more, like, psychological, like, thought of why they decided to dump the person. It can't just be because of that person, you know? They say it in the moment, they're like, oh, it's because I never really loved you, cap. Oh, you're not good looking, cap.
Oh, that's true, yeah.
Like, they say it in the moment, but why did you fall for that person in the first place? You just saw opportunity, at the easy opportunity, and you jumped for it.
True, and then when you see something better, it's just like, yeah, I might just leave.
So you, yes, you need to have the ability to like resist and to hold back and stuff like that. But I feel like if that's your number one priority in life, get to that point in life and then find your person.
Okay, yeah, I get what you're saying now. That's true. You shouldn't just like, just because a relationship seems appealing,
mm-hmm,
but your goals you want to reach, you shouldn't just jump to the relationship, right?
Yeah.
Especially if you're goal oriented. You shouldn't sacrifice that just because, oh, I want someone to talk to and ish like that.
That's what I'm saying. And I mean, like, you know, that's like, as long as, you could also do that like the opposite. You can get with someone and then go to your goal, but you both have to have the mindset of like, you know, people who are like, they work when they work and they play when they play. Like there's no crossovers. Like you're two independent people that thrive together but are singular minded. Like you both have dreams and aspirations. She wants to become this, you want to become that. You guys promote each other and you go forward. If you have anybody feeding off another person, it's not gonna work. That's like, because if you come into the thing and then like, let's say you're holding a chick or you're holding a dude who is like, who's holding you back from what you want to do, and then they do this prank on you and you inevitably switch, who's really the bad guy singularly. Because, like, of course, you're the bad guy for actually deciding to move on. But
yeah, obviously,
if you break it down, you were never really happy in the first place.
And that's what I'm saying. It kind of exposes who you really are. It kind of exposes what you've been thinking, everything.
That's what I'm saying. So don't get into a relationship like that. Find, go to where you want to be first, and then decide to find someone you want to share this amazing time in your life with. Or if you find someone who truly is a ride or die, and they have their own goals in life. Because I feel like strong relationships are when both people have their own goals and aspirations, but they love each other. You know, you're not piggybacking off each other. You're adding more to each other.
Yeah, that's a good foundation.
That's what I'm saying.
That's something everyone should really like strive for.
Yeah, like it's not. What is it? I'm not gonna say it's not fair. It's not bad to like be like a singular-minded person, as long as you truly love your partner, you know?
Yeah.
Like, you wanna, cause at the end of the day, you are you. You live your own life. You're not living their life. You're not living your parents' life. You're not living your friend's life. You're living your life. You wanna love this person cause you wanna love this person. But
true,
you wanna make your life the best it can be with this person that you chose. So you gotta go out and you gotta get your own guap. You gotta find your own bread. You gotta make your person, right?
Beautiful.
Yeah, and then from there, once you have your relationship with you, that's when you can just put, it's just like a benefit, really.
And look, when that female or that dude has something, you know, going for them, and then you're the other, and you might crash, it's, you guys both don't crash, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because if you have someone piggybacking off someone, and then the main leader crashes, both of you crash, right?
Pretty much.
But if both of you have your own shit going, and then one of you crashes and you go confide in the other, then one person is already sound in a like a career or like a personal level that they can invest time in helping that their spouse that they love or their partner succeed again, throw them, you know, get them back on their feet. So yeah.
Bring up good points.
You know, I like to keep these thoughts to, you know, to myself, but it's like, I hope people will like see this and like think about it, because it's like, no one, like I said, I don't hate anybody in life. It's very weird, you know, but like, I feel like hate is just a thing you shouldn't keep. This hate or this aggression towards people for no apparent, come on. We can help each other.
I can't even pretend like I can hate you for like a day, but then the next day, if I can't dap it up with you, then honestly, let that shit press you for the rest of your
facts.
Life. It's not business.
I can't hate people like that. It takes too much out of me. Emotional investment that's not positive is just, I can't do that. But yeah.
Guys, let's cut this inspirational talk. Yeah. I know something's been going on with you. You told me something yesterday. I feel like you should explain it.
Oh.
Let's talk about that. Let's talk about that. On the topic of relationships, you know,
you want to talk about relationships. Okay, disclaimer, I'm not in a relationship. For whoever is watching this right now, this is just a thing that me and Ziko had, a private chat. But do you want me to say your point and then build on that?
Nah, build the story up first. Talk the story first so that everyone knows and everyone has their own opinion, right? Now I'll put in my point.
Yo, I can't be doing that because, you know, it's just exposing.
Hey, yo, leave names out.
Bro, are you mad? This is going to make it so specific. The person's going to be like, oh, I know it's me.
All right, make a hypothetical. We'll call it a hypothetical that really happened.
Okay, but can I use some of the keywords that you wrote down? Just to help.
Sure. You use what I said.
I'm gonna use like three words. Okay.
This really happened, but because we want to keep privacy and stuff.
So hypothetically, so here's the situation, right? Let's say you know a person, right? And you and that person are okay. You know what? I'm gonna use Shawn Mendes and Camila Cabello. That's perfect situation, right?
I don't know why you keep up with those people, man.
That's not Senorita, bro. I wanted them to be together.
I don't care.
Okay, fuck you. Shut up. I'm gonna use them as a situation. So if people don't know or people know, basically they were friends for 5 years in the industry. So I'm gonna use this kind of situation. So you have a friend of yours, right? A friend of yours who you've known. It doesn't matter if you've known them for a while, but you guys are really close. Like, you've established that perimeter, right?
Yeah.
Now, let's say once upon a time, or like in both of your cases, from both the perspectives of the people, you once fancied the other person. So you and your friend can't be same sex if that's what you're into. But listen, we're talking about opposite sex. So let's take a boy.
What's the other one? Wait, what's the other one that is like the cues or?
Oh, the pan gender helicopter with the little
unicorn guys.
Yeah, the attack helicopter people, the kind of thing. Okay, so look at I'm literally doing visual interpretation for the camera. So here's boy and here's girl, right? These two are close friends, very close friends, right? So boy one at some point in the time has fancied this girl. Remember, they're still friends. He's fancied it. This person maybe has not at that same time, but we don't know. Never made it clear. So this person, over time, this person loses hope and whatever that kind of stuff, right? And they go back to being just, you know, thinking just about this person as a friend. Now, fast forward, girl one fancies this person, but never makes it apparent, right?
Yeah.
And so that means, you know, she starts thinking of him differently, but he's unaware of it. And then time goes by and nothing is said. So the moral is communication is lacking, right? But basically, after a while, this person goes back to being singular, and then they're both friends. Keep in mind, the constant, whatever stays constant is that they're friends. They've been friends. But every time these two have decided to fancy each other, it's been at different times. It's never been the same. So fast forward, let's say that happens multiple times or whatever, all kind of stuff. Now, let's take girl one's perspective, right? Let's say one fancied a dude, right?
Yeah.
And guy one knew about it, but at this point they're just friends, right? Let's say they talk, they flirt, all that kind of stuff, right? They still do that, they're friends. But now that has changed slightly because she fancies a dude, right? Now, let's say fast forward, you know, he's been knowing that she fancies it 3 weeks, 4 weeks.
Man said fast forward like 6 times. How far are we going?
Shush, I'm giving a timeline so people know. Give me a look. Basically, now, girl one and whoever that dude was decides, I don't know what happens, but it's not informed to guy one. But they stop doing things, and this person decides to now, essentially, what's the word? Fall back. To this equation right here, this equation. Now, this time, however, girl one makes the flirts or the conversation or the language, like the jargon that they're using, is
that's a jargon. Good lord.
Shush. Is very, very flirtatious and incorporates a lot of dialect that you wouldn't have anymore from like a normal friend kind of thing. So that's why I bring the Shawn Mendes thing up. Shawn Mendes and Camila Cabello shot that video, Senorita, which is a fire song. But in that song, they almost kissed.
That's really dumb.
In that song, they almost kissed, and they had the internet blowing up and stuff like that. Now, look what happened. They're supposedly in a relationship. They were caught kissing on camera, out in public and stuff like that. People are all nosy about their shit, right? So imagine that situation on the most like general of levels with these two people. That first initiation has happened. And she's firing shots like it's World War I. And this person is picking up on the shots, but because of all this history that I just said, it's not.
You don't know what to do.
You don't know what to do.
I'm gonna explain the story better.
I'm about to edit anything you say.
Hold up. Hypothetical guy one doesn't know how to approach this girl one because she's making advances on him, and it's just like, well, we're friends, and then you have this whole other guy you were talking to, and it's just like, where's this going?
And the history has been very flirtatious too, but at this point in time, you're still friends. Remember that.
Yeah, I want to hear everyone's opinions on this, because like,
They're gonna watch this far.
Yo, it's fire. This thing, it's what happens when you watch the full podcast, you know?
Leading on to that, I asked, because Ziko is one of my main dudes, so I texted him, right? And I told him the story without the fillers, right? And he said, oh, you want to say what you said?
Ah, no, you can say it.
Okay, so he specifically texted me saying, in a situation, girls treat good friendships like fallback relationships, and it's weird because they're denying themselves of something they've always wanted. So, I looked at that and I was like, because hypothetically, the situation that I'm talking about could never happen at this moment in time. It is just, you know, it's more like this is happening as a if, or like a maybe. It's not a solid thing. It cannot be a solid thing unless like it's, I don't know, I can't go in too deep because it's gonna spoil more things than game. But basically, shush. Basically,
oh shit.
What? You said shush. You said
names. Yeah, I'm putting names. Hold up, my bad.
But basically, yeah. So, yeah, I don't know, I'll just keep it, I don't care. I'm still single. Stop everyone who's about to text me saying, oh, it's this girl. Oh, I heard it. I saw your podcast. Shush. Still single. Leave me be. But yeah, Ziko said that. And I, you know, let's talk about that. Okay?
All right. Let me explain what I mean, right?
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
I've also been in that kind of position as well, where it's just like, you know, you're a good friend. You don't really overstep your boundaries. You know, you treat your girl right. You treat your friend right. And then, you know, she might be going for other guys. You're not really pressed about it. You might have liked her at some point, but, you know, it's just like, yo, for her, let her live her life.
Mm-hmm.
And then everything goes left. She comes back to you when she starts saying things, and you start thinking, yo, is she into me? Like, why is she saying this? Like,
mm-hmm.
I don't understand why if girls have something that they like someone they treat as a friend, but they have so much in common, the energy is the same. Why not go for them instead of just going for disappointment after disappointment? And I mean, obviously you're gonna find like the one guy who's he's gonna be there for you for a while, but like there's always someone who matches you almost perfectly. Like, why don't they go for that? That's always been my thought.
I feel like, cause I've heard it all the time, but you know when you have a friendship or someone and then you make the advance, like you make it clear, like you're not beating around the bush. In this situation,
yeah.
Both of you are beating around the bush, right? In the situation I just said for the camera, right?
Yeah, yeah.
You're both beating around the bush. But when, you know those times where you have a good friend and you make it apparent that you want to be more than just a good friend, what is the most of the responses if it's not yes? It's that I don't want to ruin this friendship.
Yeah, no one wants to ruin the friendship.
People are fearful of taking that leap. And it's with probable cause. I mean, it's with probable, like, you know, reason. Because, you know, if you fuck up, you're not going to have that person
to fall back on.
Yeah, that's not gonna be one. Yeah. Cause it's gonna be awkward now. Like, going back to friends, if you don't have the mentality, like I truly have the mentality. If I had done something with someone and it didn't work out, I will 110% go back to you as a friend. I will not.
Hey, yeah, that issue didn't work for me.
I can do that. But the thing is, for the only way it can succeed, if only one person can. Because the other person will make it awkward if they can't do it. You know what I'm saying?
True. Yeah.
So I've made it apparent in my mind. I've made it a thought, a muscle, that if you do something with someone and then it doesn't work out, do not disrespect them. You shared this time with them. You shared the friendship with them. You valued the friendship. That's why you made this jump. Go back to that friendship you valued so much. Make it seem like nothing happened. The problem is, even when two people have that same mindset, what makes it hard is when you guys are talking as friends and you start being flirty again.
Yeah, that brings up stuff that...
You gotta nip that shit in the butt. You gotta be like, no, we stopped it for a reason. We're just where we left off. That's it. No?
That makes sense. I mean, I just brought that up because I thought about it. It was just like, never really made sense to me. I'm not a girl, so I don't know what they're thinking.
They're not guys. So yeah, the thing, we love and we hate our opposite sexes.
That's true.
But we can't live well without them, physically. Actually, nowadays the scientists say that girls can produce babies like Mary. So we're about to be not needed no more.
We're running out of business.
We're running out of time.
it's actually raps for us.
Yep, it's facts. But yeah, that makes a whole lot of sense. And you know. If this helped out anybody who's been, you know, beating around the bush, don't beat around the bush, because when the signs are there.
Yeah, let's give him a little PSA, right? If you beat around the bush, you're gonna miss out.
Someone else is gonna come and trim those hedges.
Someone, hey, that's wild. Yeah, I didn't talk about it like that. If you beat around the bush, yeah, Josh is right. Someone's gonna go in, mow the lawn.
They're about to mow the lawn. They're about to put some fertilizer on that. They're about to. All that. You're about to come. Fuck, keep hitting the camera.
You're around the bush. It's not worth it. Just be straight up. You might get rejected, but at least she's aware, or he's aware, or it's aware. You know, I'm out here.
Rejection in everything can cause drive, bro. Like,
that's true.
Like, let's say if you get rejected from a job, right? Yes, there's a reprieve. There's a time where you feel down and stuff like that, and you're like, oh man, I didn't get the job, stuff like that. But you're determined to go out and conquer or get something better. Same thing with, you know, girls. If you get rejected by a girl, yes, your niggas may give you stick, your girls may give you stick. It doesn't matter. What you do is you get back on that horse and you keep trotting. You keep going at it. Because
taken from a guy who's been rejected a lot of times.
Sure, no, what the hell? You trying to at me? I'm smooth criminal, baby.
Okay. And expose yourself on this podcast.
I'm good. I like this podcast.
I thought so.
I'm about to keep it. You know what I'm saying? Don't do any more of this, please. But yeah, no. You know, just don't beat around the bush. PSA, don't beat around the bush. Just be direct. You know what? I heard something from someone, and I'm so... It's my mom. Thanks, my mom, for this. My mom told me something. She said, the worst you can hear is no. In like the most, like I know that sounds like it sounds different when you hear it, but I'm saying, like, let's say you go to a job interview, right?
Yeah.
You don't get the job. What do they say? No, we're not hiring you, right? You go for a girl, she doesn't want to go for you. She says no, right?
All right.
There's no harm in asking. The worst you'll hear is no. You know? That's what I'm saying.
Like, yeah, but who wants to hear no? That's what
I'm... But I feel like, personally, it may be different for everybody else, but that feeling that I get of, like, sitting there and waiting and, you know, contemplating and chewing the idea over about going for someone or going for something, it's worse than if I went to the person and they said no. Like, that feeling where you're chewing... That video where you're chewing that idea up and stuff like that and it's eating you alive versus that rejection... The chewing me up part is worse, I feel personally.
Yeah, for me it's rejection, man. Sometimes you want to be rejected. Especially like when you build up the courage and everything, you know, you set yourself up, everything seems...
Don't lose that courage. Don't lose it. That's the thing. Don't lose it. Keep it with you. Move it on. There's gonna be someone that finds that attractive. And guys, PSA, confidence achieves a lot. You know what I'm saying?
Who are you gonna be telling people confidence achieves a lot, or whatever you just said?
Ziko don't have confidence. That's why.
I really don't.
That's why.
I won't pretend.
He does. It's okay. Because you know what? Because Ziko does, you know what he does? He walks in the room, right? And the gals look at him.
Don't be putting me out here like that.
They like 6 foot, big man, black.
Don't be putting me
out. You know, all that kind of thing. And then he goes, opens his voice.
Hi,
Shorty, how you doing?
You're so funny.
Hey, I propped you up and I humbled you. In two.
You haven't been humbled yet, have you? You haven't been humbled yet.
Of course I've been humbled. These rejections,
I can humble you
these
right
rejections
now.
Have humbled me. I'm joking.
But you know, I got a story too.
Okay.
And I want people's opinion on this too. Because people might say I'm twisted for this. Like I'm whack for this.
Anything that's gonna get my video taken down by YouTube?
Nah, we gonna keep names on there.
Okay, go.
So I'm working a job right now.
Mm-hmm.
And, oh yeah, I'm working a job right now. You know, I'm working, making my money. And so one of my coworkers, kind of paying, you know. And it's just like.
I feel like I know this story. Yeah, go ahead.
But the person's cuffed.
Uh huh.
Cuffed, right? So I'm thinking, yo, why don't I just, you know, break the cuffs? Come through. And so people be like, Ziko, what's wrong with you, man? That's messed up. But I don't really see the issue with it. You know what I mean? Especially when it's like hot girl summer and everybody's like putting off that energy.
I'm telling you, bro. Like, look, as long as the dude is not your best man, your friend.
No idea who that person is whatsoever.
Then, yo, if she's down to ride the Wadena, then basically, that's not your fault. That's her fault.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying, right? So it's just like, but some people are like,
I'm about to get thick backlash.
You gotta respect people. And I'm thinking, I give you a lot of respect as it is. Mm-hmm. So you don't need to know this.
Man, I'm gonna get thick backlash because of this, bro. Because I agree with you. But yeah, as long as he's not your man's, and not you're not interfering with a friend of yours who's trying to go for this girl. Any way, shape, or form that dude is related to you by friendship or by family or stuff like that, that's a no-no. But if that person is a nobody and that girl's eyeballing you and you're eyeballing her, you might have to take her into the ice room and make it a little bit hot in there. You know what I'm saying?
Oh my!
That's how I feel like the mindset should be for like guys, right? It's just like if you don't know the person and there's no connection. Slide in.
So Ziko just exposed himself that he doesn't believe in relationships. Huh?
You know what? After a couple failed ones, it's just like,
Yo, trust me. I believe in you. I believe the same thing. I don't care for relationships anymore. I really don't. Yeah. If I, it's not like when I'm in one, I'm not 110%. But it's rare. It's very rare. That's what I'm saying. Like I'm gonna be, 110% faithful when I'm in one, which is whenever one happens. But I'm not looking for one. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, right now I feel like you kind of want a bit of both. Almost like friends with benefits. You know what I mean?
Friends with benefits. Man just picks up the phone and dials.
That's live, right? But it's still it's someone you talk to and you chill with. But then you know, it's down with it. It's live.
But look, listen, that could be another topic. Friends with benefits, it's not for everybody. People who get too emotionally, who tend to get emotionally invested should never be friends.
It's raps. Never.
Because you catch feelings for someone that's never going to love you like that.
You're not built for that lifestyle.
And me, bro, I will tell you like it's day at 10 a.m. Bro, I'm trying to slide into your pum pum, you know? And then dip.
You're a dog, cuz. You're actually a dog.
No, no, cuz at the end of the day, at the end, no. At the end of the day, whether that person gets hurt by that, like by the fact that, by the fact that you guys did something and then you cut her off, whether she gets hurt, whether, you know, she cries, whether, you know, this is for guys and girls, you did all that you possibly could to inform that person that you're going down a path that you're choosing to accept.
Yeah.
If I'm telling you from the cut, yo, baby girl, I'm not the relationship type. I'm just a guy that, you know, you can have friends with benefits, or we can smash and go, or we can hook up one time, that kind of stuff. And then she says, all right, I'm down for that. And then you do exactly what you said, and she calls you a deadbeat, a dirtbag. Or like, you know, because she decides to get emotionally invested or he decides to get emotionally invested. Who's in the wrong?
You can't blame them.
Who's in the wrong?
You can't blame them for investing.
Thank you.
Right? So are you telling me that like, if you made yourself very clear from the get, and then, you know, person still gets emotionally invested, and then, you know, after you just cut, she's upset and she feels all bad and everything like that. You don't feel bad on the inside. Your conscience isn't like, damn, I kind of did this.
Nope. Because I gave her the tools.
You're built different, man. Oh my God.
I'm telling you, I did every... Because what more can I do? Sympathize? Why am I sympathizing? I gave you a situation so that she could... Look, the sympathy, she could have literally... She or he could literally have... Because I'm doing it both perspectives for the guys and girls. That person could literally have avoided that situation by saying, oh no, that's not what I'm really looking for. I'm an emotional kind of person. And then you say, cool, I get it. Move on. There are 7 billion fish in the sea. But no, I made it clear. I said what my intentions were. She said she was down.
I'm soft.
Yeah, you a soft nigga. You a soft.
I'm just soft. I'm a
baby nigga.
Hey, relax. I just feel bad, you know. My conscience can't be like, damn.
You got your heart ripped out of your thing.
It's just like, even though I know what I came in here for, I built it up. I saw the anticipation in her eyes and I just went, nah, peace. Like, I feel bad with that. I just feel bad with that.
You know? I'm the Tin Man from Alice in the Wonderland, bro.
You mean the Wizard of Oz?
Oh, God. Yeah. Yo, people about to be on my head for that. Excuse me. No. Wizard of Oz and Alice in Wonderland are two different things. A lot of people are doing that whole stampede and all that kind of stuff. People are partying till their eyes come on, man.
I wasn't there.
People are just like, whoa. People are drinking like 4-5 days like straight from like 6 to 12, like from night, like doing some. I'm like, y'all
are gonna fail, bro.
Y'all are trying to
it's like party. I don't know what it is. Whatever one it is, nothing's dead.
People are partying till their eyes turn black, bro. What you talking about? Like, it's satanic out here, man. People are drinking unhealthy amounts. And the reasoning is, I'm trying to get all the party out of me before school. Cap.
No, that's the biggest lie I've ever heard in my life.
People go party when they go out to school.
My life.
Big facts.
But yo, are you down with this black men don't cheat movement?
What is this movement? I know bare black men. Yo, everybody cheats. There's no.
Are you sure it's not black boys?
What do you mean black boys?
Yo, no one ever said black boys don't cheat. It's black men don't cheat.
Ziko, shut up. Ziko, shut up.
No. Hear me out.
What? Say it.
A man knows how to handle their business. They're responsible. They maintain this level of, like, you know, etiquette and proper, like, just proper good looking and everything like that. Making sure that they get...
Are you talking about the 10% of the world? Are you talking about the 10% of men in the world?
I don't know. I'm just saying, right?
My guy said, boy, kept it together, good looking. My nigga.
Pause. We don't go like that.
No, I'm not saying. I'm not saying it as a gay. Okay, you. I don't know why you're saying it gay. I'm saying that, like,
I don't know what you're alluding to.
No, people. You're trying to say, like, well kept, independent. You know,
yeah,
those kind of guys.
What I'm talking
that's
about.
That's like a small percentage of niggas in the world.
Black boys is like you. The ones who gonna cut someone off and just have no remorse whatsoever. So, you know,
why you wanna be on my head? I told you I gave them.
I'm saying is,
they chose it, not me.
Black men don't cheat. Black men don't cheat. Black boys. No one ever said black boys don't cheat. That's what I'm trying to say. Black boys, they will probably cheat, and that's how you know you're dealing with a boy, not a man.
Yeah, I mean, like, no, you can't say a specific race doesn't cheat. That's bullshit.
And then we can say all people don't. You can say all men don't cheat. Keep it like that.
Really, nigga?
What the fuck kind of stupidity is that?
Hey, if you're a boy, you gonna cheat. If you're a man, you're not gonna cheat. Simple
you're
as that.
Bro, I know bare adults that cheat, bro. Nigga, look. Cheating, cheating is right now. I'm telling you right now. Cheating is not, it affects boys, men, girls, women, all that. Like, race, gender affiliation, what is it, religious affiliation, all that kind of, like, all that stuff, bro. It doesn't matter where you come from, your culture, all that kind of stuff. Cheating is a universal thing that's done or not done. Because when people say black men don't cheat,
yeah,
who are you accounting for? The black men you know or the whole population of black men?
The whole population of black men is that big, you know that.
In the world? Are you mad?
No. Hear me out before you get it twisted, right? The black men who don't cheat are few in number.
Yes.
But, like, black boys who cheat, that's millions.
Nigga, listen here one time.
I feel like you're missing my point, you know?
I know, I understand. No, I understand the separation you're trying to make between men and boys. I understand that.
Yeah, I'm not saying men like every guy.
I'm saying that you can't categorize it by color, because even if he's a man or he's a boy, he's still black. You can't say black men don't. You can say boys cheat, like, you know, you can say, you know, young adults cheat more than adults. You can say that kind of stuff, or like you can make, but there is no one singular race, depending on if you're a young adult or you're an adult or you're a teenager or kind of stuff. Like, there is no gender, no, not gender. There's no gender, there's no, like, color, skin color, ethnicity, culture kind of stuff that does not cheat. Cheating is like a universal thing.
Alright, so from what you're saying, I'm guessing you're not down with the movement.
No, you know, like, okay, if the movement...
Got some nice t-shirts.
If the movement is that we're stopping cheating, then...
That's the movement.
Okay, I'm because all for that.
They even got a song. They got a song.
I'm all, look, I'm all for that, right? I'm all for that, like 100%. Yeah. Like, I don't cheat like that. Like, I'm very faithful, like I said, 110%.
No.
To say that you black men or people haven't cheated in the past is bullshit.
I don't know, no one's ever said that.
What?
Men cheat sometimes.
When people say black men don't cheat or white men don't cheat or Caucasian men, I mean not Caucasian, light-skinned men don't cheat or all that kind of stuff, they're saying it as a timeline. It's a timeline thing.
Yeah, but
when people have that marker that like, oh, this kind of person doesn't cheat or kind of stuff, like, or that whole ethnicity or that whole race or that whole kind of stuff, like, you can't account for everybody who isn't part of this new movement to stop cheating, because what we should say is everyone should stop cheating. Why are we just accounting? Singularity, I'm looking at the camera now. We should be a codependent society rather than an independent society. Because if we want things to change, if we want humanity to be, you know, a thriving, wonderful, friendly place with like people who support each other and stuff like that, everyone's minds need to change. Because so long as there's ignorance and so long as there's an appalled nature to not, you know, conform, then we're not gonna get anywhere in life.
That was beautiful.
Man, that's inspiring, man. You should put like God bless America or something behind that, right? That was inspiring.
America needs to be blessed by God, man. Do you see what Trump did the other day? He sent those like oh my God, bro, it made me so mad.
Wait, what?
Basically, on the news, there was these progressive lawmakers that were challenging something that Trump did, like I think like a law or something that he wanted to do, and he was like, he literally addressed them by saying, "Go back to the country you came from." And these are like Africans, Arabs, all that nigga. I'm like,
that's on like everybody's head.
Nah, that's so disrespectful, man. Don't.
Or as disrespectful as anything, but I still kind of find it funny.
I mean, like, imagine, you can joke about it, you can laugh about it. But I'm thinking when you get down to the
country,
when you get down to like the core problem, I'm saying that like, if you want to have a civilized conversation with someone, do not get personal. Do not just attack them. Attack the point that both of you are addressing when you come together to talk. That nigga just went out and said, alright, you know what? Fuck your opinion. Go back to the country you came from. That's exactly what he said.
Facts. But I mean, I'll keep up with that stuff a lot because, you know, Canada, that you living nice. Big up Canada.
You living nice, big up Canada.
Nope. Girl, I woke up, came on this podcast. That's how it's done.
That's the kind of determination we need in life. You hear that, guy?
Not just that, man. I'm dedicated to the cause.
Yeah.
For the man. I don't know. Sometimes it's fun to be ignorant, man.
Hey, but I want to give... That's the whole point of the title of this. The tea. I want to give people the ability to say what they want to say. Talk about what they want to talk about. In the freedom that, you know, no one's going to... I'm not judging them.
I won't judge you.
If my like bar or my comments judge them, who gives a crap? They got to... Like, and if I blow up, then, bro, that just adds like more of a thought. More people can connect. Like, I bet you this that we just talked about, bare people who listen to it are gonna connect somehow, at least on one of these 4 points.
Facts. Someone has something to say. If you have something to say, leave a comment. I don't know what else to
do. Yeah, facts. I ain't ready. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, you know what to do. Like, subscribe, share it with friends and family. We know this channel is growing. We want to grow strong, and I know you guys can do it. Comment if you guys enjoyed this. Ziko, you want them to comment as well?
Yeah, leave your opinions. You know, send them to Josh. Like at least some topics.
Yep. As I said, my socials are going to be right here. Ziko is going to be in the description too. And it was in the beginning, so make sure you check him out as well. And if you do want to be part of these, because it's really fun to make, and I want to give people the opportunity to speak, DM me, snap me, that you want to be on the next one. And I will make time. It is not easy. It is not hard to get these, and I want people to have a voice. So, hope you guys enjoyed this video. As always, I will see you guys in the next one.
All right, peace, y'all.